Hello. So in this episode of Writing Notes, we're going to do something a little more technological than we tend to do in this series. I'm going to show you how to provide feedback on a Microsoft Word document. So especially in our current moment where we are living through a pandemic that's making it increasingly difficult to work face to face with people, providing feedback electronically is significantly important. This is also a crucial thing if you're doing peer reviews or something like this, which, as I talk about in my video on peer reviews, which you should be seeing a link for in the top corner, this is a major component of the writing process. So I want to show you how to give feedback on a Word document through a couple of different methods. So the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to find this review tab up here at the top. And you click on that, and that's got a number of different options. So the first thing that you want to look for, this is useful for small scale changes, revisions, editing, things like this. If you look for the tracking section, you do want to make sure that all markup is selected because that's going to show you all of the comments that you give. But then you want to click this track changes button. And then if you edit or revise anything, that's going to show up for your reader, for the person who's looking at this later. So I've put a couple of grammar and mechanics errors into this first clause here. So I'm just going to go ahead and correct those. So we need to capitalize the, we need to capitalize the T here because that's the first word of the sentence. And so what you see here is that it's taken out the with the lowercase and it's put in the with uppercase. The other thing is I took the W out of this ownership. And so again, in this case, we've got that introduced here. I'm going to take out this word. Even that word's fine in the sentence, but I'm going to take it out anyway, just to sort of show you. If you delete something with track changes on, it shows up as something deleted. Now, what your partner can do, the person who you're reviewing for, if you right-click, you can accept the deletion or reject the deletion. So I'm going to go ahead and accept the deletion, and then it's automatically going to make that change. The same thing here. I'm going to accept that insertion. Similarly, let's say I thought there should be a paragraph break here. So I'm just going to press enter to start a new paragraph. And you get, and so this is a kind of tricky one because you don't necessarily have something in different colored or with strike through, underlining, whatever it is. You have just this break here. But what you get is this little line on the side that indicates that a change has been made there. And so once you figure out, you can right click here where the paragraph break was made and accept the insertion. So that's the most sort of basic nitty gritty on the sentence word level type revisions or feedback you can give. But let's say you have a larger scale concern that you want to address. So let's say there's something I wanted to say about Appia here. There's something I wanted to say about this particular reference to Kwame Anthony Appiah's book. What you want to look for then is the insert a comment option, or in this case it's listed here as new comment, even though the little pop-up explanation thing says insert a comment. So you highlight the text that you want to comment on and just click this button. And then you get a bubble comment here along the side. And here, you can write out more substantial feedback, including questions, objections, clarifications, etc. So, if you have a question about whether, about what something means, for instance, if you're unclear about a sentence, unclear about a reference, unclear about the context of something, whatever it is, this is a good place to raise those questions. If you think something is working or not working for a particular reason, this is a good way to point your reader directly to the particular portion of the text that's working or not working. So this is a really useful tool for sort of medium scale concerns, things that are not as minor, not as editing-y as you could do through track changes, but that are also specific to a particular portion of a paper. Now I'm going to turn track changes off for this last one. And I'm going to drop down just a couple of lines, because the last thing that you can do is to leave what we call global feedback. So that's overall comments about the document as a whole. And I typically put it either a few lines down under the end of a document, or you can go to insert and insert a page break, which is going to automatically drop your feedback to the top of the next page. I'm not going to do that for this, but that's purely an arbitrary choice. What you do want to do, however, is in some way mark your text, your global feedback, as distinct from the document itself. So this can be as simple as clicking italicize or bold or underline, and then type your global comments. And that's going to give your reader a clear distinction between the body of their text and your feedback. So that's one way of doing it. That's typically what I do. Another option that you have is you can change the font color. So my partner loves purple, so I'm going to put the global comments in purple, and that gives your reader a clear visual distinction between their text, which is probably going to be in black, and your text, which is now in color. The one thing, if you decide to do this, the one thing you do want to make sure you do is that you're using a very dark color. You're using something that's going to give a contrast, because if you use a very light color, like say gold accent 4, lighter 80%, your reader is not going to be able to read that. So you want a darker color, because on a white page, that's going to make it much easier to read. So that's a crucial thing. So another thing you could conceptually do, although I think this is not as common, is you can actually increase the font size slightly. And so that's going to, again, make your text stand out. But the reason I probably wouldn't do that is because larger font sizes tend to indicate that something is more important, and I don't necessarily know that you want to send that message visually. Oh, the other thing with writing comments in colored text is I would avoid red, just because there's a tradition going back to instructors marking physical copies of papers, where red was used to mark an error or a mistake. And so that's still, people still sort of associate red comments with, here is all the things that you've done wrong, which is not necessarily the approach that you want to take in responding to someone else's writing. You want as much as possible to try and be supportive and to try and indicate things that have worked well, and then offer ways of solving any weaknesses. So, those are your three techniques for giving peer feedback through Microsoft Word. The track changes corrections, which again involves turning on track changes and then making your edits. Bubble comments, which are going to draw your reader's attention to specific pieces in the text and allow you to give them more substantive feedback. And then global comments, where you're going to respond to the document as a whole. So these are three useful techniques, and they're going to make it much easier for your reader to navigate your feedback.